Hi, and so here we are at the end of 2025. The beta release of Home Assistant 2026.1 is now available, and I will show you what it brings to the table. It's a minor release because developers deserve a holiday too, but still, there's enough to show. Let's get started. Here we are at the home dashboard of Home Assistant, which you can generate automatically in Home Assistant. And some things have been changed to the mobile version of it. So let's make it smaller. And what you can see here is now we have an option Summaries here. And that shows the amount of lights that are on, the status of your climate, security, media players, weather, and today's energy. So if I click on lights, I get an overview of all my lights. Of course, I get a lot of errors because this is my test environment. And if I click on climate, I get an overview of all my climate entities, etc. Well, let's take the weather, and weather, you see the weather card, and that's it. Another thing that has been added to the home dashboard is this devices option. So if I click on devices, then it will open and it will show me all the devices that I have in my system. And there's a lot of them, so it takes some time to load it. So that is also new, so I can go quickly to all the devices in my own system. Next to that, if we go to Home Assistant to Labs, System Labs, and I've showed this in the previous video because it was released in the December release, then you can turn on purpose-specific triggers and conditions. If you have turned that on, you get a different interface in the automations interface. So I go to automations and scenes. I'm going to create a new automation. And what has been added this month is that there are new triggers added. So I'm going to trigger, and if I, for instance, search for button, then I see there's now a trigger button pressed, and I can select all the button entities in my system here. Okay. The same goes for climates. I have a lot of triggers for climate now. Climate control device started heating. Climate control device turned off. So I can choose that, and then I can choose a target, and I get to see all my climate devices here. That's also really handy. Okay. Another one that has been added is device tracker. Now I see entered home and left home. So if I click entered home, I can choose a target, for instance, my phone, iPhone XS, and I can see when I entered my home now using this trigger. And another trigger has been added, and that is for Humidifier. Those are these triggers. I do not have a humidifier myself, but you can trigger now on when humidifier started drying or when the humidifier turned off, etc. Another one that has been added is the light trigger. And now we have triggers for light turned off, light turned on, light brightness changed, light brightness crossed threshold, and alarm armed night. I'm not sure if this should be there, but okay, it is there. Okay. Next to the automations, there's been added something to settings, and you might have already seen it when I switched to Labs. Oh, let's not save this. So there's now a section here that shows a link to all my protocols. For instance, Matter, or I can go to Bluetooth, or I can go to my tags. And this is shown based on which protocol is enabled in my system. So you can see more or less in your system, if that's the case. Then the last thing that has been added is in the energy dashboard, there is now a date picker at the bottom of this screen, which is always visible. That was the thing that people were complaining about, that it wasn't always visible. So now I can go easily to another date. So for instance, to yesterday. Well, of course, there's no data because this is my test server. I can go back to today and I get all my daily data back. So that's basically the things that have been added to Home Assistant in the 2026.1 release. But there's more. Of course, there are integrations, new integrations for Air Patrol, eGosh, Flush Plus, Fish Audio, Fresh Knopf Tracker, not sure if I'm pronouncing that correctly, to be honest, Homelink, Watts Vision Plus, WebRTC. Well, you can go through this list using the link in the description of my video. There's also improvements to existing integrations. Let's see, Meta SmartThings, Fritzbox OpenAI. Well, again, you can go to this list yourself. And there is, of course, other noteworthy changes. For, let's see, there's a gallons per day unit now. There's also a volume control support for the Meta integration. The statistic graph card includes a link to the history panel now, etc., etc. So those are the things that also have been added as noteworthy changes. And of course, we also have backward incompatible changes, for instance, for CoolMaster, Tailscale, Unify Protect, Telegram Bot, or VE Sync. So if you make use of these or one of these, go through them, read the release notes, and do not get surprised when you install this new version of Home Assistant and something doesn't work anymore. So you might find the information right here. Thank you for watching this video. It would be really cool if you spend a minute liking this video and subscribing to my channel if you haven't already. This really helps the channel grow. And if you find my videos helpful, you can sponsor me monthly, just like these awesome people do. You'll find links to Patreon and Ko-fi, as well as instructions for becoming a paid channel member in the video description. I'll see you soon in my next video. Bye bye!